So let's learn on how the US dollar impacts will happen in 2014. Investors, boards, CFOs, and corporate treasurers take heed. In 2014, the US dollar and its impacts will surprise those who are not prepared. Not because 2014 will be the year of digital currency like Bitcoin kills the banknotes, it won't be. And not because the Chinese yuan is taking over the world, it isn't. The dollar is the currency to watch next year for a less exciting, though no less impactful reason. The likelihood of it in strengthening is much higher than weakening, and that appreciation will hurt multinationals that are not prepared. So what makes the challenge greater is that the dollar won't strengthen equally across the board, but will against some currencies that mean quite a bit to corporations. To understand why, let us take a lesson from recent history. So what were the lessons that we learned from the impact of the yen devaluation? Before there was an elected prime minister in 2012, Shinzo Abe promised to revitalize the long stagnant Japanese economy in part by forcing the Bank of Japan to weaken the value of the yen. Abe was elected by a large margin and in December 2012 led by the central bank to begin the competitive valuation and is now regarded as the centerpiece of Abenomics. By some measures, the policies are working. Since Abe's election, the yen has fallen 25% against the dollar and focused around the 100 mark. The yen's fall hit many US-based multinationals hard. Among currencies that companies cited as impactful, the yen was the most cited in the first and second quarters of 2013 and the second most cited in the third quarter. The reason why is twofold. One, a weaker yen makes the dollar relatively stronger, which makes US exports less competitive than Japanese exports in global markets. Consider, for example, a car manufacturer in Japan and a hypothetically identical car manufacturer in the US. The Japanese car at the end of 2012 cost 1.7 million yen and $22,000. The American car cost $22,000. At the end of 2013, the same car will be more expensive, but less expensive in the US. Devaluation has been both a boon to Japanese companies. For example, in the 6 months to September 2013, 96% of Toyota's operating profit increase was attributable to the yen's fall. A weak yen, too, can also significantly impact multinational companies that do business in yen. Multinationals with revenue in Japan, companies like Varian Medical Systems, VAR, Nike, Procter & Gamble, get relatively fewer dollars for their yen as the currency depreciates. Indeed, US companies in the range of industries have blamed the yen for eroding revenue. Those with expenses in Japan, on the other hand, benefit paying relatively fewer dollars for the yen as the currency depreciates. It took three quarters, but bottom line impact from the yen has been so significant and so sustained that it has forced companies to finally rethink their currency risk management programs. Investors have told CFOs and the CFOs their treasurers, we do not want to go through these kinds of losses again. The US dollar's impending rise, not going through these kinds of losses again, will require a change in the way multinationals approach currency risk management. If those companies that have realized nearly $12 billion in losses in 2013 keep doing what they were doing or they have done, they will continue to see those kinds of impacts. Where will it come from in 2014? Well, we'll see currency volatility from a range of countries. Some surprising, some not, but companies will also have to deal with currency movement right here at home. The appreciation of the US dollar, for example. Why is the dollar likely to rise? Well, because, number one, with the appointment of Janet Yellen as the new head of the Federal Reserve, there are expectations of a bit more inflationary environment. The kind of environment that would result in rising interest rates and increase attractiveness of the dollar. Furthermore, the Fed is poised to roll back its bond buying as soon as the economy appears healthy enough to grow on its own. While the Fed kicked that can down the road this year, it can't do it forever, and most signs point to the economy being healthy enough sometime in 2014. We are not likely to see a stronger euro. While it appears that Europe is emerging from its deep and long recession, the EU is not out of the woods yet. And if the euro strengthens significantly, that could stymie the little momentum the economy has. So the European Central Bank will likely do everything it can to keep the euro down. Weakness in the yen will continue. Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's depreciation of the yen to drive Japanese exports competitiveness in an attempt to kickstart the economy has worked well in the years since it began. The Bank of Japan has articulated a goal of 2% inflation, well above the current levels below 1%. Fundamentally, the factors behind a more expensive dollar are less critical to corporations than the impact of the move. Anything that results in the dollar appreciation will impact U.S. multinationals, decreasing American export competitiveness and eroding U.S. dollar revenues. So what is a corporate to do? A few months ago, I shared the screen on a news program with a financial markets commentator who said the companies simply could not move very quickly or frequently to adjust the underlying exposures and mitigate the risk. That was true at one time, but not anymore. Today, many corporations are able to achieve increasingly common benchmarks, like limiting the balance sheet impact of the currency fluctuations to less than 1% of earnings per share. In 2014, management teams that do not take a more proactive approach to managing the risk of a rising dollar may find themselves explaining to shareholders why currency impacts landed on their bottom line. Savvy investors and boards take heed. Those kinds of impacts are less acceptable than they have ever been, and more importantly, are avoidable. Thank you.